How do diabetics lose belly fat? Abdominal or central obesity, a term for excessive stomach fat, has been associated to insulin resistance. Therefore, obesity in the abdomen raises one's risk of developing prediabetes and type 2 diabetes. Diabetes can be controlled and the risk of developing prediabetes and type 2 diabetes reduced by losing weight, especially abdominal fat. Since weight loss affects the entire body, it is impossible to put efforts simply on the stomach. Weight loss methods are based on a healthy, low-calorie diet and increased physical exercise, nutrition, and the loss of abdominal fat. Moreover, 9% of the U.S. population has diabetes, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention's 2014 data, and 86% of those with diabetes are overweight. ADA recommends using a range of eating behaviors as part of a calorie-reduced meal plan for weight loss. Dash, the Dietary Approaches to Stop Hypertension, or Dash, diet and plant-based, lower-fat and lower-carbohydrate programs are all examples of these dietary patterns. Diet and exercise programs with regular monitoring by the American Diabetes Association have been shown to be effective in helping people lose considerable amounts of weight. Exercise and weight loss. Diabetes Care, a journal published by the American Diabetes Association and the American College of Sports Medicine, suggested that persons with type 2 diabetes engage in 150 minutes per week of moderate intensity exercise to improve blood glucose management and lower their risk of heart disease. If you want to lose weight, you may need to exercise for at least an hour a day for the majority of people. According to a report published in the 2007 edition of the International Journal of Obesity, aerobic exercise was found to assist people lose visceral fat by increasing visceral fat loss as they exercised more. A small research published in the March 2005 issue of Diabetes Care suggests that strength training may potentially be beneficial. Men with type 2 diabetes reduced more belly fat when they did 2 weekly sessions of progressive resistance exercise, according to the findings of this study. Thank you.